have with our kids. So after a while, it doesn't matter if you're from Teach for India or, you know, who we are and what we do. It's those 50 kids we come and teach every day. And it's just the kind of bonds we form with them and the love we have for them and the love they have for us. It just drives us to come every single day, even when we're really tired. So I think that's what would be the biggest driving factor for us.
And I think the fact that you know there are those 50 kids waiting for you every single morning, and however tough a day you've had before, or that morning where you're like crying together, but I think just those people waiting there for you, the parents wanting to talk to you, I think that kind of you know, helps you get up every morning to come back here to teach the kids.
Right, so we had an hour long practice for the annual day, which is next week, early next week. So the kids were hard at work for the last couple of weeks, and after that what you witnessed was basically a closing. So in the closing, what we do is we make sure that the kids go through the whole day, encapsulate what all they've learned, kind of summarize what all they like, what they didn't like, relax, meditate, have some quiet time, quiet their energetic minds a little bit, and just go back happy. So that's what our closing was about.
First year we had to plan for these things, but when we started our second year, I think it came to us more naturally. That was very important, to integrate everything we do in our classroom, because in isolation they really don't make too much sense. So I think this year it's been a more natural process, where every activity we do, be it on a Saturday or even for the annual day, we don't want it to be in isolation. We want it to be like, you know, a wholesome education, you know, for the child. So I think that's what you saw today, where we kept bringing our values like respect, teamwork, and even the kids are now able to articulate those values, are able to share examples, and I think that's like the whole process they've come through.
Didi gives us some work to do. We do teamwork and do the work, and we don't fight in teamwork. We share and talk in English with our team.
Anyone don't do homework, then Didi put crosses that page, and like that. Didi crosses every single day, don't do homework, then Didi put crosses.
So growth is often not easily seen. It takes time and you feel like beating your head against the wall a while. But it isn't. You see it after a certain period of time, and suddenly your kids are just picking up whatever you're teaching them, and you can see that change in them. So I think my advice would be, just be patient, just keep doing what you're doing, don't lose faith, keep the belief in your kids, and they'll make a lot of progress.
And I think it's not just academically, but yeah, even like today, yeah, you all came into class, we were just so proud with the way they spoke, or the way they, you know, communicated what they were feeling and about their class. And honestly, did not expect this few months back. They wouldn't speak a word in English, they wouldn't write anything.
Yeah.
And there were times that we'd say like, what are we doing? You know, there's something that's not working right. But all of a sudden, it's all falling into place. The parents are invested, and you know, so, and as we come to the end of it, we're pretty proud of what we've achieved with the class. And we feel that we're leaving them at a really, you know, safe
strong place
and strong place for the other fellows to come and, you know, help them grow a lot more.